It's a spot in Toronto's West End that feels like its own village, and it used to be. Welcome to Then and Now, the series that brings Toronto's past back to life. I am Morgan Cameron Ross. Today we're talking about a neighbourhood in Toronto called Roncesvalles. It's a north-south street in Toronto's West End. Here, just east of Hyde Park between the odd intersection of King, Queen and Roncesvalles, and the odd intersection of Dundas and Roncesvalles. Here, if you take a look at the Dundas and Roncy intersection around 1910 and compare it to today, it's almost unchanged, except the bank's now a Starbucks. But briefly, it was also Mr. Pinky's hefty hideaway in the 2007 film, Hairspray. Take a look down at that other intersection. Well, check it out in the 1910s, 20s, 50s, and today. Remarkably similar, except the stores have changed. The neighborhood began as rural, then developed starting in the late 1800s. You see, Hyde Park in the Roncesvalles neighborhood was viewed as distant. In fact, a large number of Torontonians living around here had summer cottages around here, the Hyde Park area. By the 1920s, the neighborhood was being developed as quite posh, similar to its neighbor, Parkdale. The Review Theatre, right here, is one of the oldest remaining cinemas in Toronto. The library down the street was built as one of the coveted Carnegie Libraries in 1916, as you can see here. By the mid-20th century, things were changing. Parkdale and Roncesvalles were taking on a different and slightly less posh persona. The vibrant Polish community, though, came in during these years and really added some life back into it. Portions of the community still there to this day. It truly is one of the very few remaining neighborhoods in Toronto that still feels like a little village. No large buildings, very few corporate companies, and some really great food.
That's it for this week on Then and Now. I'm Morgan Cameron Ross. Catch you next time on Narcity.